animal shit. Beer prices. Weird dreams. Strapless dildos. It's Sunday night, and you know what that means. Welcome to Point of Viewer. I am Viewer himself. It's going to be one of those weeks. This is Point of Viewer, a W2M network presentation, a part of American Whammy Media. Don't always count on me to get that right for a while. Believe me. Yeah. If you're tuning in, first of all, thank you. If you happen to be watching us live, facebook.com/W2M Network, twitch.tv/W2M Net, twitter.com/W2M Network, or tuning in on your podcast platform of choice. Again, much appreciated. Good evening, main disembodied voice of doom.
What the fuck?
Okay. I can explain.
You did, first of all, konnichiwa bitches. Second of all, you better. Question mark.
So, remember what I talked about whenever I heard that song that we have for the intro?
Do I need to say, we're gonna need a new fucking intro already. God damn it.
I'm not saying it's a bad thing. I am just saying with,
damn it all to hell.
I'm just saying with recent imagery that I have been searching for on the internet, that imagery has been invoked whenever I hear the song.
I you know what? I don't even know what to say to this. I really don't. If I did, I would say it. That's where I'm at.
Well, you want to at least go ahead since you had to scramble during the intro and get your drink review out of the way? You may need it after our opening.
Give me just a moment, would you?
Okay, because apparently I have to take care of something.
Oh, sure. Hi, friends. The main disembodied voice here. Apparently, Eric, a viewer, has had one hell of a week. So, we're gonna go ahead and have our thing that we do here on the network, on this show, the main disembodied disclaimer of doom. We have nothing to disclaimer. I just pressed the wrong button. So I'm trying to make it sound like I actually know what the hell I'm doing around here. No, in reality, we are going to hashtag bet up. Wait a minute. That's also the wrong button. No, we're going to do the main disembodied voices drink review. And do not mind the dust and crap on my hoodie here. It is cleaning week here at the Casa de Disembodied Voice of Doom. That does not roll off the tongue well at all. And this week, continuing on our drink review series from last week with the Stubborn Root Beer, we are featuring another root beer on the podcast. I picked this up at my local Sam's Club a couple weeks ago. It is called Olipop Classic Root Beer. Of course, my screen hates me, so it's not like it's putting glare all over this can. But there it is. I don't know. It says Classic Root Beer Sparkling Tonic, so we'll see. I'm a little apprehensive. I didn't see the sparkling tonic fact at first, but let's find out, shall we? Oh, man, you open that up and it smells like a root beer. Okay. You know, that ain't bad. I feel like if you refrigerate this, and for the record, it actually did come refrigerated. I actually had to pull this out of a refrigerated case at the local Sam's Club. But I feel like if this was actually served cold and not just like room temperature, which for me is about 70 degrees, this would be really good. It definitely has all of the notes of a root beer, but it also, true to its name of having like plant fiber and like you can see it on the can there, you know, prebiotics, botanicals, plant fiber. You can't see it because this damn camera won't autofocus, but I promise you it's there. As a fruit fly lands on the can, apparently he's interested in it too. You can kind of taste a little bit of the plant fiber, but this ain't bad. I've had worse root beers. It's hard to fuck up a root beer.
I saw that while I was at Publix.
Sam's, like a couple weeks ago. And like I said, well, you had to step away for a moment.
Yeah, chicken caper. Funny of all things tonight. Anyway, continue.
Again, it's hard to fuck up a root beer. And this isn't like a fucked up root beer. You can definitely kind of taste the plantiness to it. So it detracts a bit for me. I think I don't want to say this is the first negative drink review we've had on the show, but it's definitely not. It's definitely going to be the first not positive drink review we've had on the show.
That's fair. So what are you giving it as an overall score?
I think I got to give it a 70. Like, it's drinkable. I'll drink it again. But the only way I would buy it is if it was on sale like it was at Sam's. And even then, at the price point that I bought it at, there's better options because root beer's cheap.
Because I was about to say, I've seen different cans and different flavors when I was at Publix. I was intrigued, but I wasn't going to pay a lot for it.
Yeah, I paid $6 for a six-pack. So, that's why I say, there's better price points out there. Same $6, I could have went and got a 24-pack or 36-pack or whatever the hell the bulk pack is. Of A&W.
Or be like me and get a bottle of wine and have a $1.50 left over. Yeah, I think that's the second time I've made you speechless tonight.
No, it's this root beer. I've got to give it like a 60-65.
Okay.
Again, not great, not bad, but there's an aftertaste, and I'm feeling it now. And
yeah.
That is definitely rolling it down a bit.
Yeah, I had a bad aftertaste of grapefruit juice in this fruit juice drink that I had. The aftertaste definitely takes away from it.
Ah.
So, as I said, I had to step away for a chicken caper, specifically chicken wings, and negotiations were made. It's actually kind of fitting with what happened this week, as McNugget the Rooster is no longer with us.
That's nice.
I went into my driveway. It turns out it was asleep. And then the next day, I saw that it was off the side of my house in a little front yard corridor going into the backyard, dead. So I had to go ahead, spend some of my Friday taking a shovel, putting it in a plastic bag, and putting it at the curb. Because there was no other way that the city would come and take it away otherwise. And they still haven't, so guess what's going out in the trash on Wednesday?
said dead bird.
Yes. And I also, in a bonnet hat, long sleeve shirt, and cargo pants, in 90 degree weather, took some time in ad hoc with a little bit of bleach and everything, cleaned up the shit out of my driveway. So at least it's a bit more presentable and hygienic. Even in death, that damn thing tortured me.
Now that's a good root beer. I got another case of the stubborn root beer that we reviewed on the show last week. Partly because John didn't get one, and I felt bad. So he now has his one.
Nice. Very nice.
You know, I think I have to, I think I'm going to, I think I am going to have to modify my review.
Oh?
It's hard to fuck up a root beer, but you fucked up a root beer.
This is not a good night for drink reviews, apparently.
Like, let me be honest here. It's okay to drink. Like, it's okay on that first sip, right? But when you get this, like, just horrible aftertaste to the point where I'm like, I need something else to drink to wash this flavor out. To me, that's a fail.
So how far down are we talking now?
I mean, it's automatic. A fail is what? A 50, right? So I gotta give it the highest I can on the automatic fail scale, because again, it doesn't taste bad, it just has a horrible aftertaste. And that horrible aftertaste is really killing me right now, to the point where I had to open up a different can of root beer.
So we do indeed have our first negative drink review of the series.
Yeah, I might have to try to, I don't know. I think we'll let John have one for his next Nielsen ratings and see what he thinks. But I don't know if I'll continue to drink that. I might try it refrigerated, because it was refrigerated to begin with, right?
Okay.
And I don't see anything in the ingredients list that would lead me to believe that it needs to remain refrigerated. It doesn't even say on the can, keep refrigerated.
Mm-hmm.
It's just for whatever reason. Oh, okay. Actually, yeah, it does say store refrigerated. But still, like, it's just a whole bunch of plant extracts and shit.
So basically,
apple juice concentrate, lemon juice. Other than that, it's quite literally a whole bunch of different roots and flavors and, like, plant flavors and stuff.
Am I wrong in thinking that apple juice and lemon juice are not normally in root beer?
No, they're not.
Okay. Okay, good to know. Not just me. So, you're saying at the end of the day, your drink review is an incomplete?
At the end of the day, I'm saying that my drink review's a fail.
Okay.
I don't know if it's an incomplete. I don't know if I could give it an incomplete.
Well, you're like,
Good. It's good, but aftertaste. And, like, the aftertaste is a problem.
Well, I mean, you were the one who also just said about issues with storage and it being refrigerated, so I don't know if that factored in your decision or not.
You know what? We'll give it an incomplete, and I'll put one in the back of the fridge, and we'll come back to it for next week, and we'll have it on hand, and we'll have a drink and a half review.
You're lucky I can easily make a banner for that.
Because we'll re-review it when it's cold, and then we still got plenty more drinks to go through. I still got one of those Mountain Dew flavors left. I believe, what is it, the watermelon? Yeah, I got the watermelon Mountain Dew hard seltzer flavor to do still.
Ooh.
And then I'm sure I can scavenge something around here. Lord knows we got enough drinks in this house. It might become the main disembodied wine review.
Considering it's not about my...
The amount of bottles of wine I have in this house, trust me, we could... I could do wine reviewing for the next... 6 months? Yeah.
Considering it's how I got my hands on a nice Chardonnay today, that wouldn't be a terrible idea.
So...
So
I'm, I don't know how else to put it.
So, at this point of the show, I gotta ask. I know with all of the chaos that has abounded between everything at work, everything here at the network, everything else, have you been sleeping okay?
Kinda, sorta? I haven't had the weird dream lately, but my sleep has kinda been like... I'm sleeping in spurts, and I don't like it.
Well, again, a diphasic sleep schedule is not a bad thing. It was actually how humans normally slept pre-industrial revolution.
You would know these things.
I'm sorry, I look at half as interesting as part of my YouTube binging. Granted, I'm not taking my ass any time to learn Ixquil. You can forget that shit. But still, they've got some good videos. And in a very digestible format of only 6 minutes apiece.
Well, I mean, that is the average person's attention span these days.
But the reason why I ask, and I'm glad that you brought up the dream, is this is twofold. Since the fact that we've gone...
Look, you need a segue. I provide a segue. That's how this works.
Do you see me getting mad at you? This is actually perfect. I get to get two birds stoned at once with this segment. It's a good thing.
Just make sure you don't do it on air, buddy. Otherwise, standards and practices is going to have to come in out of nowhere.
That was a one-time thing. We had been going for about 4 hours, and you know that, okay? We have recognized this, sir. And that was just a batshit show that night.
That was a batshit show, man. We'll have that up this week for sure, folks.
And he already knows and beats me to the punch. Yes, the three-part point of viewer land speed record episode will be available on YouTube and other platforms in short order. But
unfortunately, I've had personal stuff this week that has taken me away from sitting at my computer as much as I'd like to.
Well, I mean, it's understandable. I mean, hell, sometimes I've been able to sit at my computer but not do anything. Other times, I haven't been able to sit at my computer. And the fact that now that we've gone to the blistering hot portion of the year, that's further altered my sleep patterns. Although I do so in the comfort of nudity. But that's not important.
I mean, you really want to know how I'm sleeping. I'm probably going to have to get a new box spring and frame assembly. Because my current one is finally at that point where it's so fucking old that it's actually giving out.
Yeah, but I would wait to do that as long as possible. So that way, when you get your new one, it can be properly christened.
Really?
I'm just saying, man, that's what I would do.
I mean, you're not wrong. I suppose you're probably going to suggest that I have some nice cake in my new bed as well.
I mean, it's not like you're inside my head or anything, but you're wandering around to some familiar territory.
Uh-huh. Yeah, some bitch.
You know how anyways, I operate, but...
I do know how you operate.
But, and so not only have I been dealing with no more than 7 hours of sleep at night, and this morning dealing with 5 hours of sleep before my nephew came over, quasi-unintentionally, I was prepared to go to sleep sooner, but it didn't happen. A few days ago, I had this particularly weird dream where I was back in Maryland. Now, for those of you who don't know, I was actually born in Washington, D.C., and I was in D.C., well, right outside of D.C. for a few years in high school, moving back after, you know, some personal family stuff.
Right.
I had this dream a few days ago where I was back in Maryland, back in high school, are nervous and freaking out about going to school, even though I had already graduated. That's something that has been wandering on my mind ever since. Why okay. there, which I have never dreamed about Maryland, even when I was living up there, why high school, and why at that point to where it's not quite even modern day or anything, but I had already left.
Right.
That's the kind of one time in the past month that my subconscious has really upset me a little bit. So I've been, you know, wondering kind of what the fuck that means.
I can understand that, yeah.
So hopefully, as I get a little bit more regular sleep, especially since I may not have an early morning appointment tomorrow, that can be sorted out. And for a while, I thought that I would have had 3 tutoring sessions tomorrow, back to back to back, but as everybody tries to schedule it around the same time, it may end up being as few as 1. So Monday's going to be a continuation of all the work stuff in particular I've been dealing with the past couple of days. Good thing is, I've been making decent money and I've actually been able to afford groceries.
I mean, being able to afford groceries is important. Yes, I've been there before.
Yeah, and this leads into a bit of a rant, especially what happened today. And I know you've got one, too. What the ever-living fuck is up with beer prices? I mean, granted, I don't always drink beer, but when I do, it's either Chihuahua or Natterdays. Both of
La
which...
La cerveza are... más fina. Y si usted lo quiere mandarme un poco de cerveza... O mi amigo, un poco de cerveza chihuahua. Usted puede mandar un correo electrónico a podcasts@americanwhammy.com.
No recomienda que usen Twitter y mande un tweet.
Nosotros somos profesionales ahora. Tenemos el correo electrónico.
Ah, I mean, it's a fair point. Again, you mentioned upping our production value. But seriously, not only am I mad because I can't get the beers that I like, but for the beer that's available, $18 for a damn 12-pack?
Yeah, that...
When the fuck did this happen?
And- If I knew, I would tell you.
And I mean upwards of like $3 just for a simple Mountain Dew hard seltzer tall boy. I mean, this ain't right. This ain't right at all.
Oh, no, the inflation is bullshit. But I mean, also, did you not hear the news about how Florida is now the most expensive fucking state in the country to live in? Which is amazing because normally California or New York are beating us pretty handily there.
I'm sorry, the fuck?
Yeah, that was like last week's news.
I swear, corporations come to town and all of a sudden everything goes sky high. Fucking governors. Oh no, you lure the big business. It's gonna be great.
But here's the thing. It's not the big business. Florida has like some of the laxest freaking like corporate income tax and labor law and all this other shit. Where all of these companies are, you know, the ones that are doing the remote work from home shit are like, oh, well, I'm just going to move to Florida so that I can be close to the attractions and shit. And hold on a second. Sorry.
Don't tell me you're distracted again.
I was distracted, but not for the reason that you think. Everybody's fucking moving to Florida because it's like, oh, I'm going to go be close to the attractions because I work from home now. And if I want to go to Disney, I can actually afford to go to Disney. If I want to, like, have a 4-day work week and spend a weekend at Disney, oh, hey, I can do that. And it's, you know, Florida's inflation or Florida's growth is just like insanity right now because of this.
Yeah, now all y'all need to go and fucking leave.
I mean, you're not wrong.
I mean,
like, if you look at the if you look at like the most expensive counties in the state right now, especially for housing, and you compare that to the 2020 census of the fastest growing counties in the state, much less in the country, it's like there is definitely a correlation there.
I'm not surprised at that correlation whatsoever. I don't like it, but I'm not surprised by it.
Yeah. I don't like it either, but I mean, that's, you know, that's the state of the time, so to speak.
And then of all things, you've got companies like Brightline. I'm an advocate of high-speed rail. I have been for many, many years. And especially with different levels of public transportation, I'm more for trams than I am buses. I've made my stance known in a few different places about this. I get Brightline to a point. You want to connect certain parts of the state with high-speed rail. That's great. But in everything, would it kill y'all to at least do something as far as connections here with different parts of North Florida?
Yeah, that won't happen. Nobody gives two shits. I'm sorry to say it, but nobody gives two shits about North Florida. They never have.
So why the hell were all of these people moving here all of a sudden?
Because they're moving to Central Florida, not North Florida.
Yeah, no, trust me. Have you seen Jacksonville's population growth and recently as well? It's pretty up there. And especially now that we're getting a goddamn four seasons and everything else. So again, all of this, and I get, you know, Tampa, Orlando, Fort Lauderdale, Miami, all these areas. And tell me this, what's more important, Jacksonville or Apopka?
Jacksonville. I mean, when you give me those two options, yeah, Jacksonville.
Yes, but a lot of your growth as far as rail and things like that, Apopka's in consideration. Now,
it's because there's land available for him to do it.
And I get the different considerations, some land and everything else, but it's like, are y'all really going to leave us in the dust? This is what I'm worried about. Everything's going to be nice and convenient from the corridor south, yet up here it's still going to be car-centric and crazy as fuck. I don't get it.
I don't try to pretend like I know what the hell is going on with transportation. Would it be nice to have affordable transportation? Sure.
Honestly, we've really as a country have been fucked since your car companies lobbied Eisenhower to get the interstate highway system back in 56. Imagine where we would be right now in transportation if we didn't have a car-centric society.
You're not wrong. I don't think there's enough, like, excessive, at least in Florida, there is definitely not enough, like, accessible, whatchamacallit, accessible transportation.
Right.
Like, it is extremely difficult if you don't own a car to live in Florida. If you're in a bigger city, it's not as bad, but like, no, it's difficult.
That it is. That's a lot I'm just pissed off about here lately. And then
somebody who doesn't own a car, it is difficult to live in this state, man. And I, like, where I live, the transportation system isn't horrible, but it ain't great. Honestly, I think Orlando's probably the best transportation system out there.
And the fact that they're actually looking to improve. There's talks that they're going to double their Lynx fleet.
Yeah, that's good. But then again, double honestly means they're going to put it back to normal because they cut a shitload of it off way, way back in the day. When they, what was it, 2009 with the recession?
Yep.
They, like, Lynx got cut the most.
Which is a real shame because it looks like it's a good system.
Is a good system.
With the doubling of the fleet, putting it back to where it was pre-Great Recession, and some other plans of, like, different transportation centers, so you don't always have to go downtown to a main station, and some other things they're doing, I think it's going to be even better. If only we could have gotten anything close to that here. And I know not only with you not having a car and having to rely on UberEats, you've had a bit of a double whammy this past week.
Oh, yeah. UberEats in my area just sucks. Like, flat out. It's just bad.
Because, I mean, how many times have they fucked up your order?
3 or 4 this month.
Serious?
Something like that.
Seriously.
I've actually lost count.
seriously, at this point, you are just better off doing like I do with DoorDash.
It's not going to get any better because it's the restaurants that are fucking up, not Uber Eats. I've only had like two bad deliveries. The rest of them have been like restaurant mishaps, honestly.
So how the fuck do you keep ordering from the same places?
It's like... Sorry, I'm playing a league match and it's getting intense. I don't know, man. It's... I don't know what to tell you.
Funny you mentioned that, as one of my students that I worked with that the other attempted disembodied voice sent me. Yes, he's finally going to be freeing up and is trying to get back into league. I swear it's a small world sometimes. So are we talking TFT this go round or?
No, I'm actually playing an ARAM for the first time in forever.
Really? Trying to test some stuff out for our upcoming podcast throughout the week?
No, just kind of trying to get a feel for the patch notes.
So a semi yes. As you stare intently into your screen.
Sorry, I just got a triple kill. I fucking team fight, man. Why are we full screen on me as I'm trying to fucking...
Part of me wanted to see how long it would take for you to notice.
You do realize I have four monitors, right?
And?
I can see things. A lot of things.
Yes. Yes. Yes, you can. Your point?
I also have magic buttons.
So do I. Judging by the clicking, it must be a good team fight.
I mean, ARAM is pretty much nothing but team fight, but like...
So, holy shit, have we really covered that much already? That, somewhat that, although I expected you to be even more pissed off about Uber Eats.
Okay. No, I'm pissed off about Uber Eats. I can't really concentrate to... Playing and talking is not as much as I thought. It's a lot more... It is not as whatchamacallit. I can't concentrate on the two things at one time. See, I can't even think straight.
So remind me why when you knew we were going on.
Because I don't know. I felt like doing it. I'm in a mood today.
So am I. I've been dealing with...
And I just got a horrible fucking loss handed to me. And this idiot team should have fucking forfeited, and they didn't. So I had to play 25 minutes of bullshit.
Well, I mean, I've been in a mood today, too. Dealt with my nephew. 5 hours of sleep. Somewhat inadvertently made mom cry at 4 a.m. So, yeah, there's been a lot going on both ends. I don't know why I keep doing that.
Yeah, no, but to the Uber Eats topic, they've fucked up my order like, what, 3-4 times, maybe 5 times in the past 30 days. And the Wawa the Wawa near me, which is pretty much the only place open after 10 o'clock or is reasonably affordable, has fucked up like 3 times in the past week. I don't know. Uber Eats has got to fucking fix. I mean, it's not just Uber Eats, right? Like, whatchamacallit? It's not Uber Eats' fault, because 9 times out of 10, Uber is delivering on time, and it's not their driver's fault. The driver isn't following the instructions, right? Mm-hmm. And if the driver doesn't follow instructions, I just cut their tip in half, because I'm not an asshole.
Fair.
But I if you can't follow the damn instructions, you are going to get penalized, right? I am going to cut your tip in half, though.
That's fair.
And I tip pretty generously, so. Mm-hmm. But no, the big problem that I've had has just been flat out the restaurants are forgetting to put things in the bag.
Yeah, I dealt with that with Chipotle.
Like, I had one Wawa order last week where they called me. The fucking Wawa store calls me and says, "Oh, yeah, hi. We forgot to include your sub in your order. And the driver already left."
How do you forget an entire sandwich?
That's what I'd like to know. So there's only 3 things in the order. So that's really what I'd like to know. Actually, no, 4. But yeah, that's really what I'd like to know, is how do you fuck that up? But they're like, "Oh yeah, no, we're really sorry, but they already took off, and you know, we can't call them because we don't have their number. If you want to try to let them know to come back to get," I'm like, "I don't have a way to contact them either." I'm just gonna have to call Uber after the order's done and be like, because it was still in that stage where it hadn't gotten, I guess it had, the app hadn't updated that it had a delivery partner or whatever, even though it did.
This is why DoorDash is a lot more reliable. It's like, "Oh yeah, they even send a text. Hey, this person is going to deliver this order at this time. Hey, track for these updates. If you need to reach out, hey, here's your driver. Here's the info. Text him from this number, yada yada."
See, I guess in a way I put up with it because Uber does have their Uber Rewards thing. And if I get up to a certain amount of rewards, I get like points off the Uber rides, which helps me out when I need to go places. So that means even cheaper ride. And between Uber and Lyft, they've gotten to be way too fucking expensive, even before the gas increased.
Fucking gas prices.
So I don't know, right? I'm just like, I put up with it because it's like, I've got so many rewards, it's kind of dumb for me to, you know, stop now. I might switch over to DoorDash or Grubhub. I don't think Grubhub is very populated around here. I know DoorDash is decent.
Mm-hmm.
But that's the other problem. I don't live in a major city, right? I live in like small city, major city.
Yeah, you live in a...
I'm between two major markets.
Yeah, and you happen to have a home of, you know, a minor league basketball team and a professional indoor soccer team that I think is on the verge of winning a championship.
And the largest grocer in the Southeast United States. Yes, there's a lot of things in Lakeland. But for whatever fucking reason, you have to pull teeth to fucking get an Uber, whether it's Uber car, Uber Eats, a Lyft, whatever, because the fucking apps keep sending the drivers to Orlando or to Tampa, and they don't bring them back to Lakeland. That's really what the problem is.
We're not
big enough of a market where it's like, at least according to these rideshare, you know, food share delivery courier companies, where they're like, oh yeah, you just came on and you're in Lakeland. Cool. We'll give you one or two local trips, and then we'll give you something going out to Orlando or Tampa, and then you're going to get stuck there for half the day unless you turn your app off and drive back to Lakeland.
Yeah, that just reeks of stupidity. Oh, well, never mind what I said about the championship.
So, it's like, I don't know, man, right?
Yeah, I get it entirely, believe me.
Ah, damn it, you sub bitch. How do you dodge? Why do you dodge? I had a good champion. Mother fucking. That's my issue with Uber Eats.
I mean, makes perfect sense. And yeah, apparently, congratulations, San Diego Sockers.
Yeah.
They beat the Florida Tropics in the Ron Newman Cup Finals.
Huh.
So another year where the Tropics come up short, unfortunately, but kudos to them on having a fine season. San Diego was just unstoppable. I don't think they lost a single game in regulation all year. Regular season or playoffs.
Okay, then.
So, kudos to them. They ran into a buzzsaw. But I have a couple of wider topics to go on before we end the show with the big lawsuit that you told me about. You know how I am about cricket.
Okay.
I feel like
I know where this is going.
It's been on my mind a lot more, really, the past.
How the fuck are we almost at the end of the show already? We haven't even been on the air for an hour. We haven't even done an hour mark plug.
Well, I mean, like I said about everything being rapid fire, you didn't want to be under a time crunch, yet you're going on and playing ARAM, so we get through a lot of things faster. And what's going on?
I don't know what's going on, but it's like, you know, this is when I need a not Harry to show up and save me with an existential crisis about something. And when you speak of the devil, it's a not Harry. Hello, not Harry.
Can you hear us? I don't think we can hear you.
I don't think he can hear us or we can hear him. We might have to get back to him on that one.
But anyway...
I thought we had a not Harry, and apparently we didn't. I was sorely mistaken.
Apparently he's having some sort of issues.
This is a shame. But I got a good champion. I got Misfortune on ARAM, which is like fucking good.
Yet you wonder why we're already nearing the end of the show.
I can talk and play Misfortune in my sleep, okay, buddy?
All right. So, like I was saying, you know how I am about cricket. First of all, I've actually dug in, and for the first time in a couple of months, I've actually gone ahead and changed some rules in my six-a-side cricket league code, because it dawned on me. Sometimes, even with the measurements that I had laid out based on the European Cricket Network rules, for six players on a ground, it could still be a little bit too big. So instead of my 50 meter minimum, 60 meter maximum, I've actually shrunken those measurements by 5 meters. 45 to 55. And by my rules, the straight boundaries must be longer than the square boundaries. Or, to make it better, the straight boundaries cannot be shorter than the square boundaries. You can have them the same all around, but if there's going to be any discrepancy, the straight boundaries must be longer.
Okay.
So I was thinking about all of the different formats and stuff that I can manipulate, as I think we have a not hairy back.
You do have a not hairy back.
Oh no, it's a not hairy.
It
Hi,
is.
Hi, not hairy.
Hi, main disembodied voice of doom. Viewer.
Hello there. I thought we were expecting you later than this particular hour.
I ended up watching the pay-per-view at home tonight, so I was able to hop right on the computer once the show ended.
Oh, okay.
What pay-per-view was tonight?
Backlash.
Oh.
Okay, continue your cricket.
So I was thinking to myself, of all of the different formats, F5, T10, T20, I even realized of how, with the smaller grounds, how a good first class and test match would work.
As we get some weird ass fucking garbling going on there.
Well, you were the one who mentioned a second ago the sound bugging out.
Yeah, that was the microphone hitting my beard. Sorry about that.
That's all right. So I thought to myself, I had a perfect idea for a one-day format, harking back to the original formats of the 1975 and 79 Cricket World Cups, 60 overs a side. Partly inspired by one attempted disembodied voice who happens to have his own show on the network the first of every month, it hit me, okay, this could work. But I realized even more. You yourself, main disembodied voice of doom, you're very big on T10 cricket.
I do enjoy the T10 cricket, yes.
And everybody, it seems like, is playing T20 cricket. There's a preference of some form of T20 cricket or an iteration thereof, and it's really exploded in the past few years. Not to mention, you have those test-playing countries emphasize even more in stepping up their first-class domestic competitions, namely England, adding more first-class fixtures to their calendar in the middle of summer, while still abiding by the T20 tournaments. So then I realized more and more, the way that I would do six-a-side matches, a good two-day Saturday and Sunday first-class match, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday for a test match, you would still get the same ratio of wickets needing to fall per day, and I would still have the different penalties for a slow over rate, all this and that. I looked at myself. I looked at the developments of cricket and I realized I don't think the one-day format really works anymore. I mean, I've seen some one-day cricket. We mentioned before the Women's World Cup. You've got the Men's World Cup coming up next year, which the U.S. is trying to qualify for the first time ever. We've had, here in the U.S., we've got some more 50-over matches, like the different carnivals and competition types. But to me, being the cricket lover that I am, those that have noted the forgotten middle format, as they call it, I think it's being forgotten for a reason. Outside of a World Cup, I don't think it's really being prioritized, and I really don't think it should.
And you're saying this in regards to T10?
Not just T10. Your short form formats in general. T10, T20, the 90-90 Bash, the 100. All of those are big and getting bigger. The U.S. has gotten on board with minor league cricket and major league cricket, a T20 competition.
Well, yeah, that has a lot to do with American attention spans, though.
And this is true. I think that's a big part of it. But at the same time, it seems to be either a prioritization towards the short form T20 or faster, or test matches. And I personally, I don't think that's a bad thing. I'm one of the, albeit admittedly few, who can sit and watch a good test match a couple of days on end. I will sit and watch T10, T20, all of the short form cricket. I'm not universally appealed to a one day match.
I don't know. I like the T10 format because it's kind of like get in and get out, so to speak.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not 100% sure I'm completely on board with a show that, or not a show, but a sport that's gonna, you know, take multiple days to complete.
And again, you're not wrong, and I know I am in a significant minority when it comes to test matches. And I honestly think more needs to be done to test matches to make them more appealing. Same with first class matches. Because you look at what's happening in the county championship. Thankfully, you have not had a lot of draws. A lot of matches have been decided within those 4 days, some of which even faster. That's great. If that happens on a more international level and across more domestic competitions, I'm here for it.
I feel like with the attention spans that Americans in general have towards cricket, as well as the rest of the world in terms of the breakneck pace that things move at these days, I don't believe that those extended format cricket matches work to the traditional schedule of a standard cricket viewer.
And again,
well, I mean that, and if you want this stuff televised and you want,
oh, absolutely,
to become more mainstream within the U.S. at least, because, you know, cricket viewership in the States ain't exactly there.
You have to condense it to a format that's suitable for television.
Yeah.
And that's why I say the main ambition of the people at the top, USA Cricket, even though there's been a lot of issues going on behind the scenes, again, when they started the idea in getting the facilities for Major League Cricket, they said the ultimate goal is for the U.S. to be a full ICC member and a test-playing nation. I don't think that's a good idea. I completely accept that. I do.
I mean, if they try to be a full ICC member, they're going to end up catching some ass whoopings at the very start here, just because I don't think the skill level is there for American players yet on a sport that we're not as familiar with.
Similar
to like when we take our NBA players to play basketball overseas, and more often than not, anytime we play anybody outside of the occasional Spain or China or what have you, we end up blowing everybody out by 30 or 40.
Oh, well, I mean, that's
I'll take number one and two answer on the board, please. Thank you, Steve.
Well, I mean, obviously that's going to be a thing. And if you look at the makeup of our international team, our T20 or even our ODI team, you have a lot of expats from test playing nations. I mean, you even saw it yourself, main disembodied voice of doom, when we were looking at the European Cricket League. And even with some other European Cricket Network events, a lot of these T10 clubs in these countries, they have a lot of expats from like India, Pakistan, England, what have you.
So what you're saying is the basic concept of the American cricket team is a bunch of bastards from other countries.
In essence, yes. And I honestly think that's a benefit as far as qualification, especially in the short term.
I'll agree with that, but I think in terms of growing the game domestically, it's a hindrance.
It's a hindrance to a point, yes. And that's why having these facilities and having a T20 tournament like minor league cricket, like major league cricket, had put a little bit more love into cricket playing at universities, because there's basically a collegiate cricket system. I think that would be great. And for a T20 format, that's fantastic. My thing is, this is exactly where cricket is going, and I'm not mad about it. My argument, like when I started here, is why are we still, and I guess this is a big question to the ICC, why are you still doing all of these things when the one-day format is dying? For people in a lot of cricket countries, it's basically either keep where we're at with our T20s or do something to improve our team when it comes to tests. ODIs have become tertiary. That's what I'm getting at, really, in a nutshell.
I have to be honest. My knowledge is cursory at best. So I'm still learning. I know MDVD over there is starting to get more invested than I am, but like I'll sit and watch if I find one. I wonder if you guys link something inside of the group conversation or whatever.
And that's the same boat that I'm in, right? It's like if you give me a decent like T10, maybe a T20, right? That's, you know, I can live with that. That's like, you know, fast paced enough. If I see something, I want to like see it out to the end, kind of thing.
When the T20 Vitality Blast and the 100 come around to England in later in the summer, I'll send the links for it, because those are the next competitions that I'm really going to be invested in myself, especially the 100.
Viewer, You remember that thing we were discussing in our BWSR chat?
Mm-hmm.
I think we're going to go with that for our SOTW.
Okay.
The one that I just mentioned earlier, because I have one queued up on YouTube to watch.
Okay, absolutely fine. I've been seeing a couple of things with that myself. So, yeah, we can easily call that.
Not to mention, it kind of ties into the conversation about regular baseball as well. So I feel like this would be an interesting segue into this conversation for our sport of the week.
Of course.
Okay, so I missed the drink review, and I heard something about a bitter aftertaste. MDVD, what happened with that?
It had a bitter aftertaste. I mean,
Which one was it, so I know to avoid it?
Oh, it's called Olipop Classic Root Beer.
Okay. Yeah,
It's like this, like, I mean, okay, it says tonic, right? Sure, I'll you know, it's not like it's misleading advertising or anything, but I'm just sitting here like, yeah, no, it was not that great. It had this horrible aftertaste, and I'm like, yeah.
You know
it
what?
It tasted good drinking it, right? Like, I, you know, at first I'm sitting here like, okay, this tastes good drinking it. But
do you know what I have that reaction to? A&W root beer. It's fine drinking it, but for some reason it always leaves me with a horrible aftertaste.
Really?
Yes.
That's interesting.
Eric, A&W, yay or nay?
Yay, but I prefer the cream soda over the root beer.
That's facts.
Yeah, A&W makes an unrivaled cream soda.
Although, you know who has a really good cream soda? The Barks Red Cream Soda is really good.
Eh, it's better than decent. But I do still have to try the Stubborn Vanilla since, you know, somebody else already has.
Yeah, him doing his drink reviews last week is probably going to cost me some money.
hey, these things happen.
Juicers and everything, huh?
Look, I mean, I didn't get the juicer, but
yet.
I can
you haven't it. Gotten the juicer yet.
Okay, he's not wrong.
I give you credit for toughing it out for that can of root beer, because if I get something with a bad aftertaste, I'm like, nope, not doing this.
Oh, no. I went back to the Stubborn root beer.
Oh, okay. That explains it.
Lollipop is probably going to go down the sink.
Yeah. I just anything with that horrendous of an aftertaste, I can't do. All right. So what else am I catching up on here?
I don't Jinx. Know. What else are you catching up on?
I gave an update about McNugget the Rooster. Sleeping.
You do realize they Allison changed it. They came to snuff the rooster.
I don't know what it was that actually did it, though.
Regardless, it still got Lane Staley'd.
I mean, you're not entirely wrong. Having to go ahead and do that cleanup in 90-degree weather was not fun.
Did they ever come and pick up said McNugget?
No.
Good grief.
Yeah. So I had to go ahead, spend some time, shovel it into a trash bag.
I remember.
And then said trash bag is still at my curb.
What's the status process for tonight with hate mail? You guys have a time set?
Probably about a half hour after I finish wrapping up this show. So that way I can sneak in John Oliver. And then we will be ready to go with Know Your Teams, Ghana, as we continue our journey through all the teams in the World Cup.
Let me know when you get to Senegal.
Okay.
I have a rooting interest.
Oh?
Sadio Mane.
Well, yeah, but I figure, I mean, you would have a rooting interest for quite a few of these countries, given Liverpool.
England.
Hate to say it, I don't know if you're getting that quad.
Yeah, the one day of the year I choose to be a Newcastle United fan, and they let me down tremendously.
Well, what do you expect from fans? I mean, that oil money and everything from the Saudis hasn't kicked in yet.
Speaking of teams that have new ownership, what do you think about the Chelsea? What do you think about the Chelsea thing? The Dodgers owners bought Chelsea.
Yeah, Magic Johnson and crew. So it's going to be business as usual and even more opportunities, except now instead of turning something immediately into gold, you're turning gold into possibly platinum?
What is it with Major League Baseball owners buying Premier League franchises? Same thing happened with the Henrys in Boston. They ended up buying Liverpool.
Well, I mean, it's the fact that not every American wants to go to Serie A, and baseball owners seem to be better owning these clubs than football owners. Yes, I'm looking at you, you fucking Glazers.
And you cons.
I mean, they're a championship side. What does that matter?
They got relegated while the cons were the owners of that club.
Exactly. So again, at what point, what did that necessarily matter?
Okay, so where are we on the format then, viewer?
Honestly,
we are nowhere on the format because this is point of viewer where the format's made up and the points don't matter.
Well, that's, I mean, fair. there were the two last things to talk about, one of which I kind of have to wait for you. The other one, I really have to wait for you, main disembodied voice of doom.
Yeah, I mean, I'll take my monkey. Thank you. Come on, how is that not worth the monkey?
Because for some reason, you were the one bitching about how of all nights, and I have a format and everything set up, yet you're damn near apoplectic about how we're going so damn fast.
Well, hey, guess what? We've been on air for an hour and 15 minutes. Why don't we do some plugs?
Not that kind of plug, folks. Don't worry, you can stick around for these.
No. It's that kind of plug, too, because it's Sunday, and you know what that means? It's point of viewer, which means point of viewer discretion is advised, motherfuckers.
So now when I get to you on camera, you stop doing the arm motion? For shame.
It's plug time!
I never want to
give them the business with the plugs.
I never want to see you use your fist while you say that ever again.
It's plug time.
So that's twice in a matter of 2 weeks that something is being forbidden from this show. It's not me for once, so I'm on track.
All right, so I just saw the format for the last two items that you guys have on the agenda, and unfortunately I can't add anything to either of them.
See what I mean? You see? You main disembodied voice of doom? While he goes ahead and as he's calling, getting a feel for the patch and research for this week, I will go ahead and remind you that for those of you who just saw that middle finger.
Fuck your couch, Dan! Fuck your couch! They should have never gave you a podcast!
So for those of you who saw that middle...
Let alone four of them.
Those of you who saw that middle finger live...
It only took us an hour and 15 minutes for me to finally get into the spirit of point of viewer.
Well, I mean, not to mention not just a podcast or not even four podcasts, but a whole damn podcast network. As you saw that middle finger live on Facebook, facebook.com/W2M Network for now, twitter.com/W2M Network for now, twitch.tv/W2M Net for now.
For now.
And for all of those of you who have heard or will hear that fuck yo couch moment on all of your podcast platforms of choice, we remind you that Point of Viewer is a W2M Network presentation, a part of American Whammy Media.
iTunes, iHeartRadio, Stitcher, Spreaker, Podbean, CastBox, Overcast, rate and review us 5 stars on Spotify, join us on Discord, link in below. Yeah, that's creepy.
It's the Keck face. It's the Keck face.
Five stars, folks. 5 stars.
No, you know what it is.
If that doesn't deserve 5 stars, I don't know what does.
Eric, you remember Popeye, yes?
Yes.
The guy who always ate the hamburgers. What was his name?
Oh,
I know who you're talking about.
Yes. What the hell was his name?
Whatever. The point being is that's what Brian's face reminds me of when he does that hand motion. It's creepy.
Yeah.
He's too busy trying to remember the name. I half expected to get flipped off for that. I'm not going to lie.
No, that just means up there it goes. I was about to say he's probably in another team fight right now.
I was in another team fight.
What the fuck is he playing? The fuck is he playing?
League of Legends.
Of course he is.
You know, the thing that I have a show about on this bloody network?
Yeah, I have no interest. Sorry. I am not your narcosis nor sepsis. Target audience. I drove him to drinking root beer.
I am not drunk enough for you to be right.
It's a fun fact. You know the reason I know that? Marilyn Manson.
Again, I'm not drunk enough for you to be right.
You're welcome, by the way.
This could have gone one of two ways, very badly or very awesomely. Right now, it's going very awesomely. So you know what? I'm okay with this. You know what we're missing, though? We have like two gimmicks that we haven't hit on the show yet that we're missing.
Okay.
And forced gimmick infringement is a W2M Network exclusive.
Can I steer into one of those gimmicks for you? Because I did want to talk about Rich Strike a little bit here, because I feel like that's something Eric would be interested in talking about.
Well, I mean, the second biggest winning payout of a horse in Kentucky Derby history.
There you go. You're queued up, Brian.
Hashtag Ben on Bavada. 21 needs 21. God fucking damn it.
Wow, he threw in a fuck in there. It's point of view.
Please. That's right, you motherfuckers. They should have never let you niggas gamble.
Give that man a monkey.
Please gamble responsibly. If you got a problem, seek help. The number's on the screen.
Just don't let your thumb cover it.
But my thumb was covering it.
I don't know what the other gimmick is into
the other gimmick that we haven't covered yet on this here podcast, where we talk about, among other things, wet ass pussy.
Well, I mean, I was going to mention about a certain comedian on one of my Fat Pizza DVDs who could fucking get it if you would elect me and be paying attention, but oh no, you're playing League of Legends.
Come on, your leg, it's it. Let's get to the point, your leg. It's fully seek, it's fully seek.
Because I'm telling you, first of all, I am a little bit pissed off that they had to do the whole zoom in gimmick with Fat Pizza back in business. I fully intended to watch that, but no dice.
Well, I would argue that it's better to be pissed off than pissed on. Depending on your preference. We don't kink shame here on Point of Viewer.
Besides, have we not covered that I'm a pissed top around here? I give the golden showers. I don't receive, except in very rare circumstances.
Fair.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to thank you for tuning in to Point of Viewer here on the W2M Network as we currently get canceled live off the air, formerly on Facebook, Twitch, and Twitter, and occasionally available sometimes on YouTube. Where you can occasionally hear me in my best Rick James Dave Chappelle impersonation saying, fuck your couch, they should have never gave you niggas podcasts.
Viewer.
Yes.
See your body. It's a part of body. Ah. What a piss or, on you.
Or, I was going to say, more appropriately, I want to piss on you.
Haters want to hate. Lovers want to love. I don't even want none of the above. I want to piss on you. Yes, I do. I piss on you. I pee on you.
You're both welcome for that.
I'm dead.
And MDVD is done. We broke standards and practices.
Standards and practices?
What standards and practices? We don't got those stinking standards and practices on this show.
Those need not apply.
Oh, God.
You feel better now.
Speaking of Dave Chappelle, what's up with him getting tackled by that homeless dude?
Oh, I didn't know that he was homeless. I just heard that he had a vendetta against him.
No,
after Dave Chappelle personally.
Actually, no. I saw a story about this, and the reason that he did it was to raise awareness for his grandmother who was getting evicted from her apartment because of gentrification. Chappelle talks about it on an article on Yahoo News.
Okay, I'm all for protesting and everything. I'm all for raising awareness.
Yeah, but that's how motherfuckers get shot.
Exactly. Exactly.
Yeah.
Yep. We're officially being demonetized for this episode.
Cooling in my Escalade. Man, I'm paid, I got it made. Take me to your special place. Close your eyes, show me your face. I'm gonna piss on it. I don't even want it. None of the above, I want to piss on you.
Well, I don't have a lighter, but here. I'll give you a cell phone flashlight. Does that count?
Yep.
How the fuck do we all the both of us pull out lighters at the same time? There's another game. It's a podcast.
Your food. I make my life complete. Will I turn your face to a toilet seat? I want to pee on you. Yes, I do.
See, this is what happens when disembodied voices do.
Oh, Lord, help me.
I don't even want.
This was not the one I was hoping for, though. I wanted the other one.
But that one still worked?
No, that one does work, but is it at the end? Maybe?
Talking about the remix?
Yeah.
You do realize if this was the Odell Beckham version of the R. Kelly parody, it would be, I want you to shit on me.
Well, I mean, they would be singing that to him.
I don't want to show off with a little taste of the remix. Y'all ready? Here we go.
I pick you up from the club, take you home to make some love. Got a surprise, close your eyes. I'm going to cover you with suds. I'm going to give you some poo-poo.
I'm going to give you some pee-pee.
This is the remixed edition of a song about pissing.
No, I'm serious. I really do want to piss on you.
Oh, man. Oh, that's great.
I feel like the main disembodied voice is correct here, viewer. They really should have never gave us niggas podcasts.
I mean, it do be facts, though.
He ain't lying. Motherfucker ain't lying. Not to be confused with Ice Cube, who said the next motherfucker that interrupts me is getting shot. Please believe that.
Today was a good day.
Ice Tea? I'm pretty sure it was Ice Tea.
Yeah, it was Ice Tea.
You mean the dude who plays played a cop on television after portraying himself as an anti-cop rapper for like 30 years?
That was Ice Cube.
No, that is Ice Tea.
Ice T's the one on SVU. Yeah, he's a detective.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Yeah,
Tutuola. Finn Tutuola. No, Ice Cube decided to go make family-friendly RV movies instead after talking about how much of a badass he was. Apparently, everybody's morals can be changed for the almighty dollar.
I mean, you're not wrong. I mean, as we all say, if you want to send us any sponsorship opportunities...
It took the words right from my mouth, viewer.
Feel free to send an email to podcasts@AmericanWhammy.com.
Wavelength.
And of course, as always, any comments, suggestions, and hate mail. And Marty, I'm sure you're not watching this. Hell, if you are, more power to you, sir. You can send all that to s.garber@gmail.com.
Oh, I'm going to wake my neighbors. God damn it.
See, this is what happens when you give him gimmicks. Now he gets to use them.
And in the wonderful words of the great Wu-Tang Clan, diversify your gimmicks, nigga. Diversify your gimmicks.
So what you're saying is these gimmicks ain't nothing to fuck with?
Exactly.
That's fair.
The most precious thing in the world is the financial security and well-being of your family. You want to send your little ones to the best schools.
Oh, God.
Know that you've left them.
We're about to get real offensive real quick.
Nowadays, we all know that cash rules everything around us. Cream, get the money, dollar bill, y'all. That's why it's time to enter the 36th chamber and step to the roof. Wu-Tang Financial. At Wu-Tang Financial, we'll work with you to devise the best plan for you and your fam.
I mean, Smith Barney, bunch of bitches. Old time farts. You gotta know how to jack this. You gotta play this game rough. You know what I mean? In, out, get, grab, bonk.
You need to diversify your bonds, nigga.
War, invest in some nuclear bombs.
This ain't trading places, nigga. This is real life. Protect your goddamn neck. Alright?
Really? Uncensored, but we're bleeping goddamn?
All of our trusted consultants are here to meet your needs.
Unfortunately, the old dirty bastard couldn't make it today, but he sent his regards.
Because at the end of the day, Wu-Tang Clan ain't nothing to f*** with.
Wu-Tang Clan ain't nothing to f*** with. Wu-Tang Clan ain't nothing. Wu-Tang Clan ain't nothing. Wu-Tang Clan ain't nothing.
Step to the room. Wu-Tang Financial.
Step now to the wall, motherfuckers.
Now that's a company I would work for.
Wu-Tang Financial, in association with Rick's TNT LLC. Took me a second to get the name correct, but I got there and the joke worked.
So, yeah, now are you in the mood to discuss fat pizza in this lawsuit before we get out of here?
No, I mean, let's talk about fat pizza. I'm all for it.
Admittedly, and I did watch both DVDs, I'm most likely going to be perusing the wonders of YouTube so I can watch Howzo's. Looks like it's some funny shit, and I can see why the later seasons of Fat Pizza did get much better. And I'm not gonna lie, Shazza can fucking get it. Seriously, even with the voice, she can get it.
All right, I'll bite. Who's Shazza?
Brian, you would be best explained with this one, as you are the now somewhat embodied voice of Doom.
I would figure that the easiest way to explain this would be a visual representation.
I guess I could find something.
Well, he's gonna do his work, because, I mean, not all, a threesome with her and a woman with the best ass in Sunnyvale, I mean, my life would be complete. Ken McCoy might have something to say about that, but...
Speaking of needing your assistance in matters of this particular topic, Mr. Viewer, give me 1 second to find it, but go ahead and continue, and then I will
I mean, speaking of the best assassin, Sunnyvale... Fucking Johnny Boxer, man.
I swear, just a pure comedic gold from that man. It never ends.
I feel bad what happened to Maria Venuti, though.
I know.
The stroke and everything. Yeah. I'm glad she's like slowly recovering, and she's been doing non-speaking parts on the new Fat Pizza, and she looks great.
I'm forwarding it to you, Mr. Viewer.
Perfect.
I got a Shazza and Dazza compilation. I guess this will work.
An image would have sufficed.
You can watch a couple minutes of this.
Hey, Shazza, you reckon the new neighbors are a bit dodgy?
This is cavalry. Fly the plane into the building. You understand me? Dynamite. Get like this.
I wish you'd f***ing give me some f***ing attention. Instead of f***ing staring at those riff, I f***ing f***ing every f***ing time.
F*** off, you mole.
I f*** you, you c***.
This is the wrong shadow.
You want to fight a war, smart ass? Get on the Lebanese Rambo, mate. You
And of course,
why? Yeah, this is the wrong one. But...
cop when you f***ing need one. These f***ing wog can block the whole f***ing street off. Well, if little Dazza here f***ing accidentally sets his school on fire, every f***ing cop in f***ing Asheville wants to f***ing get involved.
What do you mean you don't care? We have lots of hostages. Free camera. What's that?
Look, mate, do you think anyone actually gives a shit if you blow up a bunch of bogans down at Centrelink? I mean, what sort of a f***wit are you?
Bring camera!
I mean, do it. And go back to terror school, will you? Hey, guys, anyone here give a f*** about bogans?
Bring camera! Bring
drop camera! Dead.
No! Why are you dirty?
Any minute now, my man Daz is gonna get up, and he's gonna beat the f***ing shit out of these rice noodles.
Hello!
Mother f***ing slanty eyed cats.
Wonder how I can get these f***ing smokes out of me pocket. Jesus, Kendra's f***ing hot. Wouldn't mind having a mad go at her. Wonder how you get a f***ing mail order bride.
Now where's the good looking hostage cheeks? Hello.
Oh, f***ing hell! Why don't you rip your f***ing face off, you f***ing greasy wog mother f***ing c***?
Quartered by good old Aussie know-how.
Yes, John, I'm here at Hashfield Centrelink, where 8 members of the JLKFC terror group have been foiled by this great Aussie hero, Darren Smith.
That's Dazza, mate.
Well, Dazza, tell us in your own words how you managed to overpower the JLKFC.
Well, I just...
Oh, hey, he did nothing, mate. It was me who did it. I smacked them terrorists. class with kickboxing skills because I'm a champion. He was just a hostage handler.
Isn't that just typical of your ethnic, jumping in to claim the credit for the hard work done by honest Aussies like Darren Dazza Boy Smith?
Oh, God.
It's an anti-choco conspiracy, mate.
Treat us like a bunch of stooges. Try to stooges, mate.
As not Harry just sits back and face palms. Yes, this is why we saved these for last.
To the three people,
good shit for last.
To the three people that normally watch, I'm sorry.
Sorry.
More like and you're welcome.
And or you're welcome. Yeah, I guess depending on which
way. I was gonna say. They shouldn't be sorry. They should be thanking us because we diversified the bonds.
We diversified your comedy, nigga.
Oh, I gotta look that up. Hold on.
Viewer?
Yes.
Photo sent. Sorry, continue.
Oh, that's okay. I saw. Face is familiar to an extent.
I sent it to you.
Can't readily identify, though.
Sent it to you too, main disembodied voice of doom. Check your messenger. We need help identifying.
Wait, say that again. I was looking up something else.
Check your messenger. We need help identifying.
I need help identifying.
When the guy needs a guy, you're the guy.
Exactly.
That is not my department, though. I am horrible at identifying.
I'm going to have to do some research, then.
I can, run it through some tools that I have.
I'd imagine you have facial rec software over there somewhere.
As a matter of fact, I don't.
Uh-huh.
You know,
he has to say that for legal reasons.
No, for some reason, I'm legitimately not surprised that he doesn't.
I'm surprised. I would be surprised if he didn't.
Shit's expensive, bro.
I don't disagree.
But anyway, figure we get into something jovial before you update me on this RCID lawsuit so I can figure out how fucked we really are. As he intently has that research face.
Look, he asked me to do something, now I'm gonna try.
Alright, while he researches, why don't we go ahead and bet on Bovada for a few seconds here.
21 means 21. God fucking damn it. Please
obey all local and state federal gambling laws.
If you need help, if you have a problem, the number is scrolling across at the bottom of the screen.
Did you get a
I legitimately my methods of finding things are all coming up blank.
Did you get a chance to watch the race yesterday?
I unfortunately did not.
All right. Well, then I will let you take a chance to watch the race. Watch the race by Thursday.
Gotcha. That I can definitely do.
We'll put it on the agenda for Thursday. All right. I now take it back over to the main disembodied voice of doom and RCID.
Well, the main disembodied voice of doom is actually going to play a clip first.
Okay.
This has got to be my favorite, or at least top three of my favorite fat pizza jokes, sketches, skits, segments of all time.
Got it already queued up for us? There we go. Yeah.
That was Melbourne, bro. You know what I mean? I've said it before, and I will say it again. I hate Melbourne, mate. It's shit. You know, why do they have hook turns? What, you go left to go right? How does that even make sense?
Hey! Man, what a hook turn is, you dumb bastard!
What?
Hook turn! piss off, you bogan!
And get this, a copper pulls me over. He says the new law is that you ride on a motorbike, you have to wear a dickhead fluoro vest. I'm not wearing a dickhead fluoro vest. I parked the bike, man. I was catching cabs from there.
Where are you from, mate?
I'm from Sunnyvale. Heard of it?
Sunnyvale? Ooh, Sunnyvale. Mate, this is crazy people fucking.
Hey, Sunnyvale's not the Gold Coast, mate, but, you know, it's better than Melbourne.
Are you from Sunnyvale, mate? You know
no,
nothing.
No, nothing. Fucking.
You access that Vic, mate. You need subtitles from SBS.
Cab driver, man. He was the woggiest cab driver I've ever seen.
You need Vladimir Putin in this country.
I don't know what you're talking on, man.
Now you take Putin and Tony Abbott and you go to Sunnyvale, come fucking clean it all up. Just like Ukraine, mate. Come in with their fucking tanks and boom, 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 boom.
I would like to say for the record that this is from like 2012.
And this is classic.
In no way recent.
Well, I mean, this is classic Howzo's. What do you expect?
This is Fat Pizza versus Howzo's, the movie.
There we go. Problem solved.
And we do not condone what's going on worldwide right now.
Slava Ukraini.
Boom, boom. No more Sunnyvale fucking.
And he was one of them cab drivers that don't stop talking. You know them ones?
Oh, yeah. These hipster now, they don't want taxi no more, the fucking hipster fucking, right? They take the iPhone from their fucking ass and they have this thing called Goober. You know Goober?
What's a Goober, man?
Hey, you press one button and no taxi, you get this fucking Goober fucking.
I don't need one of them apps for taxis, mate. I just do runners.
I have no more jobs because of these hipsters and this fucking Goober. Fuck you. Pull you fucking Goober.
And then he's telling me he hates hipsters.
That's wrong. What's wrong with the female underpants?
Today I'm looking for hipsters, mate. If I see hipsters now somewhere here, I'm fucking kill this poofter hipster fucking. Fucking look here, hipster fucking. Come here, you fucking hipsters.
Then he pulls up and he started bashing these guys with beads.
Hey, hipsters!
I thought it was like a September 11 thing.
Fucking Goober.
Why not? We were getting on good until I done the runner. He wasn't happy about that.
Hey, where you going, Sunnyvale? You come here. You owe me $10.85, fucking. It sucks in, mate. I call Tony Abbott, fucking. I call Vladimir Putin. I find you, fucking.
Hey, what? Oh, you want to bring it on, do you? Well, mate, bring all your friends. Because I got thongs, mate, all right?
I fix you up, mate. I come to Sunnyvale. I find you. Oh, fuck.
And that's him, Nick Giannopoulos.
When
an absolutely hilarious comedian.
I like a bigger pizza pie.
I fucking can't drive a fucking car, you fucking
dickhead. There
go you, man.
Anyways.
Ah.
On to serious business. As we resume the music here.
Of course.
More Reedy Creek news.
So, because
who doesn't love some good? Who doesn't love some good Reedy Creek news?
Yeah, fuck us up with this lawsuit you told me about.
So. Remember how I said before that this is eventually one way or another going to end up before some Supreme Court somewhere?
Yes.
Well, in order for that to happen, typically somebody has to sue somebody else, right?
Normally, yes.
Well, guess what? The lawsuit part finally happened.
Oh, fucking Christ.
Yeah. Three Central Florida residents, two from Osceola County and one from Orange County, are suing the state of Florida over the law to dissolve Reedy Creek. In a lawsuit filed in federal court.
Joy.
Yeah. Yeah, federal court. The same federal court, mind you, that is deciding to abolish Roe versus Wade, which all I'm going to say about that is simple. A woman has a right to do whatever the fuck she wants with her body, and it's nobody's goddamn interests or points or whatever in the name of any goddamn thing to do or legislate or govern otherwise.
Exactly. I mean, if you're gonna be all up their ass and not providing any sort of health care, which prenatal and immediate postnatal health care in this country is horseshit to begin with. We have crazy people who wind up killing kids. We have all kinds of issues with homeless children and everything like that. But no, you want to outlaw this and not even do the right thing in providing contraceptives and everything for those exercising personal bodily autonomy. All y'all go fuck yourselves.
Yeah. And I will say for the record, I was raised Catholic.
Same.
Baptist.
So don't tell me that I don't know, you know, yada, yada, yada. Like, no. And on top of that, there was a recent study done where it's like 60 or 70% of the population agree that Roe versus Wade shouldn't be overturned. And then there was another survey done recently that I remember reading about this week about how, like, I think it was like 45, 50, maybe even close to 60% of, I don't remember the specific number, but it was significantly high. It was not a minority, really. Of Catholics saying that they were more pro-choice as opposed to pro-life.
What?
They would vote for pro-choice legislation if it was presented to them.
They're violating the number one rule of point of viewer.
Don't be a dick.
Bingo!
But
now, if there's someone who would love to get some fantastic Christian discipline, and we're talking about the Supreme
Jesus.
Court, I mean, we're on the topic here. I mean,
look. All I'm going to say is y'all niggas need Jesus, okay? We need Cat Williams with some motherfucking First Friday choir Jesus in here, okay? May I get an amen from the church, please?
No.
Amen?
TD Jakes is not impressed.
I said, can I get an amen in the church?
Amen, brother.
Thank you. What the fuck, throwing off my goddamn gimmick. They should have never let you.
And funny
you know
is, we're talking about...
You know what I say to that?
Why don't I stretch out?
And just started grinding mud on his couch.
Yeah, I remember grinding my feet on Eddie's couch.
You remember why you did it?
Because Eddie could buy another one.
Fuck your couch, nigga. Buy another one, you rich motherfucker. Fuck your couch, nigga. Fuck your couch. Darkness is.
Buy another one, you rich motherfucker. something about me and comedic timing, right?
Yes. And it's funny, we're saying all of this now. It's like, oh, these messages brought to you by Joel Osteen Industries.
Fuck your church.
Fuck your church, cracker. Fuck your church. Buy another one, you rich motherfucker.
That's a monkey.
Do you remember why you sabotaged his church? Because he's rich, he can go buy another one, the motherfucker.
Reminds
and
me
I
that...
don't remember sabotaging nobody's church. I sabotaged his church.
Okay. Reminds me of the what was it? The thing about the plumbing where they like found $400,000 hidden in the plumbing of one of the churches or some shit when they did renovations.
Wasn't that Osteen?
Yeah, use that $400,000 and fuck your church!
Man, I don't remember the sabotage that did about his church, man. You know, all right, we'll talk about it. I got more sense than that. Yeah, I don't remember sabotaging Joel Osteen's church.
Fuck your church, cracker! Fuck your church! Godnesses! Godnesses!
Oh.
I say I'm pretty sure JTN's comment here pretty much sums this up accurately.
This our ship. They should have never gave you power.
Well, I mean, he ain't lying, but I mean, it's just the perfect way to really end the show. Cause, yeah,
I haven't laughed this good at all this week. Jesus,
it took your ass long enough.
Oh man. Okay. Anyway,
do I get at least partial credit for this?
Admittedly, yes.
Woohoo!
Simpson
style.
Back to Reedy Creek. Some people that live in Reedy Creek Improvement District are salty, and they said, "You know what? We about to sue the shit out of DeSantis." And guess what they did? They went to federal court and they said, "We would like to sue the shit out of DeSantis." And that's what they have done.
Those were their exact words, actually, on the filings. Quote, "We'd like to sue the shit out of Governor Ron DeSantis."
When Governor DeSantis's attorney was reached for comment, he said, quote, "I do not want the mental image of having to have the shit extracted out of my client in my head. We have no further comment on pending shit or litigation."
Or something along those terms.
I mean, welcome to Florida is all I gotta say.
This is when keeping it real goes wrong. No. we went way too far on that one. No, the actual story... three Central Florida residents filed a lawsuit in federal court this week saying that the bill should be declared unconstitutional because it violates taxpayers' federal constitutional rights and claim that the bill will lead to, quote, significant injury to taxpayers.
I mean,
which is basically code for that bill is going to go up and bitch slap all of them in the face.
They're also saying that it is, they say, quote, "It is also without question that defendant Governor DeSantis intended to punish Disney for a First Amendment protected ground of free speech. Defendant's violation of Disney's First Amendment rights directly resulted in a violation of plaintiff's 14th Amendment rights to due process of law." And they say that they have a right to sue because, quote, "They are third-party beneficiaries of the Reedy Creek Improvement District because the creation of the special district benefits county residents indirectly. That gives the residents suing the state the right to enforce state laws," the suit claims. Especially because plaintiffs would be affected by repealing the act the way it has been repealed. And further goes on to say, "As the district's activities included assistance to taxpayers in the surrounding areas of Osceola and Orange County, and Florida approved of such assistance, third-party beneficiaries also live and inhabit those counties." So basically, DeSantis is getting taken to court for exactly the reasons why I thought he was going to get taken to court, mm-hmm. which could be summarized up into two words, Citizens United.
Finally, that's coming back to potentially bite them in the ass.
Oh, yeah, no, if that bites Republicans in the ass, I'm going to laugh my ass off.
Oh, I have been waiting for this for so long. So now... after this, let's see what they do about it.
Well, when reached for comment, DeSantis said, "Fuck your district!" And the residents in return replied, "No, fuck your bill! You pasty-ass looking motherfucker! They should have never voted you into office."
I mean, it do be facts, though. Seriously.
But no, they, I think this goes to the Supreme Court, and I think we either A, see Citizens United overturned,
which I would be glad of,
but screw over Florida in the process.
As if we're not screwing ourselves over enough.
Yeah, but I mean, like, RCID doesn't get overturned.
No, and I
RCID doesn't get overturned, but Citizens United gets struck down, right? Or Citizens United gets upheld and Reedy Creek is struck down.
So it's basically the needs of the many versus the needs of the few.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, yeah. Let's face
this
it.
This is why you couldn't pay me to be a judge.
Therein lies the problem, though. The needs of the few help satisfy the needs of the many, though.
In this case, yes.
Because the needs of the few happens to be the largest employer in the state of Florida.
And well, guess what? Everybody who went ahead and y'all giving DeSantis 55% approval ratings and booing his reelection bid because, yes, he is running for reelection.
Yeah, but look at the fucking approval numbers. How much do you want to bet he's only getting those numbers from little tiny podunk-ass towns that rely on small infrastructure, like small town city infrastructure, which is what DeSantis and his entire cabinet have been pandering to his entire administration.
Yeah,
DeSantis doesn't give two fucking shits about major metropolitan areas because I think it's like 6 out of the 7 major metropolitan areas in the state of Florida are all blue.
I mean,
the only one that's red, I believe, is Tallahassee.
No, Tallahassee is still actually fairly blue. It's Jacksonville that's the purple dot. Trust me.
But still, that's my point still stands. DeSantis is like, no, I don't give a shit if I could carry all these small rural counties and all these small rural voters by pandering to them, because as much as this may sound offensive, but honestly, some of them are just dumb fucking hicks that don't know any damn better.
You're the one who took the words out of my mouth.
It's, you know, when you pander to the lowest common denominator, if the lowest common denominator is sufficiently large, you still win.
Exactly. So again, if he doesn't have to and he gets reelected, what does that tell you?
It tells you that Floridian citizens are idiots.
What have I been saying for years? People are stupid.
There were those of us in other states that already knew that, but
I mean, Florida Man exists as a meme for a reason, and it wasn't because somebody just went viral overnight. You know, it's a consistent fucking thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And going back to the point Jonathan said, Duval and Union counties are the anomalies, which he's absolutely right. And rule number one.
God damn it!
Plain and simple.
I feel that was appropriately punctuated.
It was.
Mm-hmm. All right.
I really hope that this gets struck down because as it stands, if Reedy Creek gets repealed, the credit rating of the state and almost every county in the state is going to like plummet all the way down into the negative. Which means counties are going to have a hard time being able to borrow money to cover budget shortfalls, which means local government shutdowns, more state bailouts, higher taxes across the board. Florida might end up having to implement a state income tax.
Honestly, at this point, it's either state income tax or we have as similar quandaries like Puerto Rico does. Either way, I'm fucking moving.
Yeah, no, I'm right there with you. I'm at the point. I'm a Floridian native, right? Born and raised in Orlando, and in the middle of the '90s, when you know it was tourism, fucking like tourism was booming, right? The glory days of Florida, if you will.
Oh yeah, I remember those days quite fondly, at least on that end.
But. I don't know what the state of Florida is going to do because they've already got impact taxes out the fucking ass, right? They have business tax out the ass. The state sales tax, I don't think they can raise it any further without a constitutional amendment at this point.
Yeah, it would all be municipalities thanks to, like Duval
thanks
and others.
Thanks to Jeb Bush. I swear, for Jeb Bush, I am an independent, right? Lately I have been more democratically leaning than I have Republican leaning because Republicans are just fucking up.
Yeah, not wrong,
but. Jeb Bush was a Republican that I could get behind.
I mean, I was down here for his second term, like when I came back in 02, early 03. Times were still pretty good.
Like, I think Florida had its best years under Jeb Bush. Aw, hell nah. Impact fees out the ass. 55 demographic will not support income tax. Well, here's the problem. A lot of that 55 demographic is going back to work because shit's too damn high. They can't live on Social Security.
Yeah.
Or some of them are being smart and they're investing into like rental properties and shit, which is still technically income.
And with all of that, with these rental properties, they're now fighting against the algorithms for a lot of big corporations that are snapping up these houses based upon, you know, the change in demographics, the rise in prices, and with the potential boon. So a lot of these companies are buying up all of these houses. Thus,
I'm waiting for some lawsuit to crash that housing bubble because I feel like that's the only way it crashes.
There's actually one company who's basically gone bankrupt because of it already. I think more companies would have to go bankrupt from it than with the lawsuit matter. How exactly that happens, I have no idea, but that's what I see happening first. But with
that,
all these companies, or you
double taxes on residentially zoned property owned by a company?
That could work.
But then you'll just have people play shady pool and you'll get people owning property when they're like some high name, you know, they'll pull a Disney, they'll pull a Reedy Creek. It's okay, well, we're going to control this by putting our own people in there that we can trust and that they fuck it up. Well, we just give them the big old ugly boot.
I don't know.
There's Reedy Creek, though, is like they're sitting there like, yeah, come on, bitch, bring it. We ain't afraid of you. We do got enough money to buy a new couch because we are rich motherfuckers.
I mean, you ain't lying.
Reedy Creek board sitting here like, hey, we're going to get through this. We'll live. Honestly, and you put me down on paper now, I think this is theatrics. I don't think that the Reedy Creek Improvement District will operationally cease.
So
it may be on paper that, you know, it has to dissolve, but we got 18 months.
So you're basically along the lines of there's going to be a hell of a lot of kabuki.
I think it's going to be, it's either going to get drawn out in legal court, and then it'll finally reach a point where either DeSantis isn't in office and a new Disney-friendly legislature says, hey, we're sorry, we're repealing this law, you can have Reedy Creek back. That's option one. Option two is it gets struck down by the courts, like finality struck down by, like, okay, it's struck down, we're not appealing it or anything, it is what it is, RCID isn't shutting down. Or that's it, really. I don't really think there is another option. Because either way, like, option three, like, even if this lawsuit fails, right? Mm-hmm. Orange and Osceola County could still sue the state.
They could.
And they'll sue the state. They'll sue the state under Florida law, saying, hey, this is an undue burden on us and our taxpayers. You can't dissolve this district because we cannot financially afford to incur $1 billion in fucking bond debt.
Yeah, I mean, it's an extra $162 million a year in expenditures without revenue.
Well, is it just that? Because you have to sit there and think. That's the numbers that they crunched just to cover the bond debt, right?
Well, yeah, and that's the main thing,
the bond debt crunched. They haven't crunched the numbers as to who takes over all of that infrastructure that Reedy Creek has put in, right? They got solar power plants, water stations, cable, telecom. Like, they're their own fucking city, literally.
So, I mean,
you've got fire departments, fire stations, like hundreds of, I don't know if Reedy Creek's up in the hundreds, but probably 50 to 60 fire apparatuses that are going to have to get absorbed. They got like 106 firefighters, I think, or something like that. All of the civil workers from Reedy Creek. Okay, sure, Disney will probably take care of them, but Disney has no need for firefighters.
No.
Right.
Well, I mean,
what about the additional costs to the sheriff's departments and Florida Highway Patrol that we haven't factored on yet for whatchamacallit?
All of those
for protecting Disney World, right?
Honestly, let's factor in
a couple extra $1 million to replace all of the signage at Disney World, because none of it is MUTCD compliant. And since Disney can't just sit there and pass an ordinance and say, well, we don't care that it's not MUTCD compliant, it's our district, it's our rules, but we say goes, guess what? They now have to conform to the counties that they respectively are in, which means every single last bit of signage has to get replaced. That's going to be millions of dollars, and, you know, of signage plus labor and everything else. Like, there's a lot of costs that I don't think have been factored into this magical $160 million extra a year thing. I think in reality, at least for the first couple of years, we're probably looking at $200 to $250 million.
The reason why I say it would be a little bit lower than two, and this is going to be tragic, a lot of those guys would practically just be laid off. Anything that would be surplus to the county, it would just be like, no, we can't. Stations would be closed. All of those cuts, they'd just be gone.
I don't think so. I think Orange County would have to keep at least one of the Reedy Creek stations open. The one right next to Disney World, the iconic one, because of the amount of call volume that Disney World gets.
And no, I
they couldn't afford to otherwise. They would have to keep those firefighters on as well. They would have to basically staff up an entire another station without the revenue to do it. Now it's going to cost $2 million a year, probably.
And that's fine. And I get that. But what I'm saying is that's one station, maybe two. The rest, like I said, whatever would be deemed surplus to requirements, they would be gone. So I think it would probably
I want to say that you're right, but at the same time, these firefighters are under contracts and they got unions and that gets nasty. And I could see them forcing Orange County to take on every single last one of those firefighters, fire chiefs, etc. onto the fire department's roster.
Yeah, that's basically going to be another suit in of itself. Because I get where they were coming from, and especially the contracts and everything. But
I can't be upset at the firefighters for wanting to do it either.
I'm not upset at the firefighters for wanting to do it. I'm seeing the argument from both sides. The firefighters would want to do it because, hey, that's their livelihood, that's their jobs. It is a very worthy fight. On the other side of the coin, Orange County would be like, look, we're fucking broke. We can't hack this, so we're going to have to take a look. You see it from both ends. So, let the shit fight continue?
I mean, yeah, that's what it is. This is fucking trench warfare. Or at least it's going to become trench warfare at some point. Maybe we're not there yet, but give it 6 months as this really starts to fucking get into the swing of things, especially election season, really deep into election season, and people need talking points and political statements.
Basically,
it's going to become trench warfare in Orlando, flat out.
Basically, from August onwards. That's when you start really with the primaries and then leading up to November.
But it's not good, right?
No, it's not.
The only way I can see DeSantis getting what he wants without affecting Orange Osceola County is if he does a tit for tat replacement, right? Like, he pulls out everything Disney associated. He keeps all of the laws and everything. You know, because he's going to want to change some things, but generally speaking, for the most part, anybody involved in the administrative operation, which obviously includes the Board of Supervisors, Faridi Creek gets pulled out and DeSantis puts his own people in. All the way down to, again, day-to-day operations people. Right?
Ugh.
Yeah.
Ugh.
But that... It DeSantis is happy because Disney no longer has their power over their district. And they have to go through more bureaucratic red tape than certain agencies of the federal government.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, that's what DeSantis will do.
Oh, of course.
And two, the surrounding communities don't have to absorb all of this bond debt and all of the other crap that goes along with it.
Right.
So technically it gets dissolved, but it's still there. Just
right.
Operating differently, but not really. Instead of Disney having a nice big, you know, rubber stamp of approval that they can do for things, they now have to jump through a different series of hoops. God. Which may or may not be worse than having had to jump through regular government hoops.
God, that's just gonna be a fucking pain.
Yeah. Disney, however, has countered.
Naturally.
Disney has come out and released a press statement back at the beginning of the month, actually, but I found out about it recently, saying that they are earmarking 80 acres of Disney-owned, read RCID-controlled, land for affordable housing developments in the southwest corner of Orange County.
Oh, boy.
It is still in the early planning stages, but it is expected to include over 1,300 units, and it will be constructed on Disneyland near the new and expanding Flamingo Crossings Town Center. Which basically reads to me as, okay, we need to get in the news for a good thing. Somebody build a new celebration.
And that's basically how it is. Jesus.
Because that's exactly what's going to happen. This is going to be a new celebration. All the way down 100%, because they're going to put this on some, like, border edge of Disney property, right?
Mm-hmm.
That they can easily annex out of Reedy Creek Improvement District.
Mm-hmm.
So that these 1,600 people can't fucking vote on the goddamn Board of Supervisors.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'm not going to sit here and fault Disney World for doing this. It's needed. Especially with, you know, the amount of shit that, whatchamacallit, with the amount of workers at Disney World that are on some form of government assistance.
Yes. Lord, yes.
It's a good thing that Disney is doing this. But I personally, especially after, and I'll put the link in our private chat so that we can put it in our description later. In fact, I'll even try something new here and blast it out to our Facebook and Twitch audiences. To me, this reads as, yep, we're making a new celebration. And they have a website and everything that they link to in their press release, but definitely
I'm staying tuned.
Yeah, same here.
Yeah.
Cause this probably won't finish until maybe 2025 if we're lucky. I'm going to give it, like, 2 to 3 years.
I would definitely say Q3 2025.
Yeah.
I'll give it a solid 3 years and change. Because shit happens.
But, because this is Disney World. If they are 100% committed to doing this, then, yeah, this will move. This project will move very quickly. Because when Disney World wants to do construction, especially given the fact that it's technically going to be being done on their property, which is RCID controlled, so it's RCID building codes and it's all rubber stamp approval process, shit will move like motherfucking, it'll move like a quickness, right?
And honestly, I'm going to say this. The reason why I say Q3, like I said, the election's in November. They're going to see how all of this plays out. with their thumb on the scale. I'm not naive. If they wind up getting like a something, if they wind up getting something akin to what they want results wise come November, they may just say, hey, we're doing this. You go ahead, cut the right deals, and we'll get this stuff faster.
It's like, oh, hey, you got a housing crisis in your county. Well, guess what? You guys just got X fuckhead governor out, right? So you help us out with X and Y and make sure we get to keep our special district status. And we'll guarantee you 1,400, 1,500. Hell, I wouldn't even be surprised if they go up on it and say like 1,600. I mean, 80 acres is a lot of land.
Oh, yeah.
1,700 units in a year.
And that's exactly what I'm thinking. It's like, hey, you get this done for us. By the time you celebrate a year in office, January 2024, come on down and you'll be able to open the community. What do you say?
And this is Disney we're talking about, so they'll throw around the money.
Oh, of course.
When Disney wants something done, you'll realize why. You'll realize it's Disney. You'll see every construction company in Florida start bidding on that shit.
They'll be licking their chops, especially now that you don't have as won't have as many projects with the SunPass lanes, since quite a few of the major ones got done, and with everything with high speed rail isn't going to be coming right away. And I'm still salty about that.
These things happen.
Yeah. But anyway, shall we wrap up? Because, man, that actually was about what I was expecting from tonight.
I mean, you know, when you finally get the gimmick infringing going, and, you know, you get me started on a good topic, then, yeah, I can definitely get going there.
Get you started on a good topic while you're not playing ARAM.
I mean, you know, these things happen.
Mm-hmm. Well, but anyway, for those of you who happen to be watching live on Facebook and Twitter, W2M Network, Twitch at twitch.tv/W2Mnet, thank you very much. And as always, rate and review us 5 stars on Spotify, but if you're on alternate platforms for those who prefer to take their podcasts orally, no worries. Stitcher, Spreaker, Podbean, CastBox, iTunes, iHeartRadio, Overcast, Google Pods, Apple Pods, if you name it, we are most likely on it. And for those who are not able to watch us live, never fear, youtube.com/W2M Network. For now, episodes will be in the archives. So where can they find y'all on social media and elsewhere?
Konnichiwa. Oh, wait a minute. Not yet. At the Andesian, don't forget, we got MSI tomorrow. Or sorry, Tuesday. The fuck did I say tomorrow for? It's a weird week, folks.
Oh, trust me, as I got some news.
Yeah, we got MSI on Tuesday. Tomorrow we've got a very loaded League to the Max or whatever show. Boy, do I mean loaded. Yeah, so League to the Max, Life is Like a Game Show on Tuesdays, with myself, with viewer here. With Not Harry, if Not Harry is still with us.
He is. At least I think he is. Yeah.
Konnichiwa, bitches.
Gimmick Infringement is definitely a W2M Network exclusive. That's guaranteed. Yeah, at the Andesian on Twitter. Oh, wait a minute. This is Point of Viewer at NSFW Andesian on Twitter. Strict and thorough vetting processes, yada, yada, yada.
18 means 18, god damn it.
Yeah, pretty much. So yeah, that's it. That's the show or something. I don't know. Eric, take us out of here, will you?
Well, since not Harry showed up, I gotta let him kind of get everything in for himself.
It's your show. I'm good. They know where to find me by now.
Anyway, at Superviewer on Twitter, as I'm stating, you must undergo a strict and thorough vetting process. However, you will be glad you did.
Remember, folks, vetting is your friend.
Yes. Yes.
Boy, have I learned that lesson. As far as the network.
Yeah, that.
Hold
things,
on.
Things will happen eventually.
Not what I mean. Not Harry. Go ahead.
Let me go ahead and prepare something to eat here in the time it takes you to run these down.
So, tomorrow, a very loaded lead to the max or whatever, where I will be the disembodied voice. Lot to catch up on ahead of MSI. And soccer to the max, where we catch up with the week and rather embarrassing news out of Manchester United. And World Cup.
You mean that Brighton ass whooping?
Yeah, that. And I'm not going to say we didn't deserve it either. I'm not.
I'm not going to say it was a bad game, but they rated Ronaldo a 4 out of 10.
Four, as in the number of goals Brighton scored. We'll be getting to that more in depth. And also tomorrow. That's right. I'm pulling triple duty. World Cup Know Your Teams will be covering Ghana. Tuesday, as mentioned, we're going to have an MSI special on League to the Max or whatever. As the tournament officially begins.
I gotta check the schedule. I'm gonna check the schedule while you're working on that.
Wednesday! Little bit of a special surprise. Well, I'm also going to be here at the network.
Oh, fuck.
What? What now?
The broadcast day is starting at 3 in the morning.
Yeah. South Korea?
No, I'm happy about this, but it's gonna suck for the live coverage.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because, like, I get off at 3 in the morning, so I'm not gonna miss the games. I can watch the games after work. It's perfect.
Yeah, that'll be great, but again...
But, doing the coverage is gonna be, like, 9 in the... Like, 10 o'clock in the morning is when the broadcast day is probably going to be over somewhere between 10 and 11 Eastern.
So you telling me, wait, do I have to get my black ass up early for these shows?
You might have to, yeah. Which means I might have to get my black, I mean, I almost said black ass.
I mean,
I blame you for this. I blame you for this.
The views and opinions of the main disembodied voice at the Napper Mine.
I mean, you're close enough, given your history and everything. I'll give you a cheek. How does that sound?
My black cheek up at 11 o'clock in the morning. Oh, man. Oh, yeah. At least they're putting some of the better games up front.
Yeah, well, the reason why I say
some
this...
Of these days, I don't know, man. Some of this might go to VOD review. If I'm going to bed at 11 and I got to be up at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, that's what, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4... That's like 5 hours of sleep. I'm going to be lucky if I'm getting 5 hours of sleep a day during this period.
11 to 3, you said? Main Disembodied.
Oh, I got to be at work at 4, so if I or at 4:30, so if I really want to push it, I can get up at 4. But still. Yeah.
The sleep is so fucked, he can't even count the amount of hours correctly.
I mean, it's like my body is already like, oh yeah, we're in tournament mode. Congratulations, bitch.
Oh, enjoy. Not only that, Wednesday, bit of a surprise as well, as not only will we be doing a Know Your Teams for the CONCACAF W Championship, starting with Haiti, I'm actually going to be making a guest appearance.
Oh, no.
I'm joining Rancid Randy on the R&R Sports Report.
Oh, no.
I'm being called to pinch hit. Yes.
Not that Rancid sub bitch.
Wednesday night, R&R Sports Report on Facebook. Yeah.
Don't forget to have your Rancid sum bitches spayed and neutered.
Well, hey. I made a deal with him though, because he specifically requested. I am going to do a 5-minute segment where I explain 5-pin bowling and all of its badassery.
Okay, first of all, Randy, rude.
What? He asked. He's like, hey, doing a Wednesday thing. I got my schedule. You'll want to, you know, come pinch hit do the show. What am I going to say? No?
Not you, him. I should have been asked too. Rude.
I mean, well, with that, you'll get not, to get your...
Not Harry is offended for regular Harry.
Well, I mean, regular Harry will be able to get his revenge on Thursday as I will join him for the Broader Swakin Sports Report.
Sports in black and white.
Thursday nights as usual. So again, you're not going to get rid of me, especially this week.
You did forget something, though.
Life is like a game show. Press your luck.
I covered that. Well, I didn't say press your luck, but... I did say we're on Life is Like a Game Show.
And if you're
not Harry just happened to not be around.
If you're interested in my thoughts on Second Chance, you are more than welcome to check out the Discord link in the show description. And if you go to the Life is Like a Game Show page on there, the public page for Life is Like a Game Show, I give my thoughts and my rating for Second Chance on there. Unfortunately, there was a fuckered up sleep schedule that led to my lack of appearance. However, I do believe that we've got that situation resolved. It's 12:45 a.m. and I'm still awake right now. So that bodes well for this week.
Oh, that's
damn it. Damn it. Not Harry. Regular Harry had technical difficulties. How difficult is it to just say technical difficulties?
Well, there were technical difficulties. I was technically asleep.
You know what? I can't even be mad at that. I can't even be mad at that. As much as I want to be, I can't even be mad at that.
Every now and then, I'm as funny as I think I am, as I've said before. All right, I'm going to bed.
All right. Good night, not Harry. So, yeah. Potentially early mornings, multiple late nights. Oh, these next couple of weeks are going to be awesome.
Oh, yeah. This better be a damn good tournament.
Sarcasm on full send there.
Well, I mean, with that, pulling, you know, double and triple duty most nights over the next month. Yeah. Standards and practices will probably not be appearing, but may damn sure be on standby for some of those streams. Just saying. But anyways, enjoy your week. Those out there in podcast and YouTube and all of the various lands, have a good rest of your night, day, what have you. And for the love of God, don't be a dick. See you next week.
Don't be a dick. Don't do it.